To study the brain, the first thing we always do is look at the data. Then we start breaking out our statistical tools to study the connections. The brain, as it turns out, is very complicated. We've been working for the last 10 years to develop foundational statistical tools where we can prove the kinds of theorems that we know and love from basic statistics, and then we've been able to apply that to answer a wide variety of questions about brain networks that were previously quite vexing for the field. Our work has helped change the field by being amongst the first to develop a number of technologies that help people deal with particularly large data. Around 2010, people started getting really large images of brains. It would take hundreds of terabytes for the entire brain. And so we built all the infrastructure that would enable people to store and visualize those data, but without having to download anything. So they can go to our website and look at the data. We were basically the first to do anything like that, and effectively the only people doing that still. We built a lot of computational and statistical tools, and so we can translate that to the industry where people are doing lots of data science. And to facilitate that, we've started a number of startups based on the work that we've done in our lab. Another way to translate is, of course, in biomedicine and health. And so, for example, one of our research projects has to do with autistic mice, and we're hoping that we can understand what's different between the autistic mice brain networks and the normal mouse brain networks and translate that into human health. Being at Johns Hopkins is important to me. I get to work with some of the best faculty in the world, both in neuroscience and biomedical engineering, computer science, and other departments, as well as the best students who are excited about the work and excited to work together. I'm most excited about working on understanding how brain networks enable people to be happy and how when they go wrong somehow, can we figure out how to make it so that those people have an easier time to thrive by perhaps enabling them to change their brain circuitry in such a way that they're happier and healthier. Engineering the future of medicine means that we're building the tools that will enable people living in the future to suffer less from various medical disorders. Our team is pioneering work in neurodata specifically targeted at developing and applying the tools to study large and complicated brain networks, hopefully to better understand human brains, both normal and disease, to facilitate better global mental health.